Hey Ben, how's it going?
Hey my man, it's going well.
Doing good, that's awesome. What do we got going on here today? I see we got the Frag tank, bare bones set up.
So we've been sitting on our hands here for a while and we thought it was about time to get this thing put together. And so today I guess we're doing a little video on setting up this beauty and telling you our plans behind it. As you can see, it's a beautiful 4 foot by 2 foot aquarium right dead center in our shop. And we're gonna put, once we get it running, we're gonna put some beautiful, beautiful stuff in, some really high-end pieces, like things that would be like, wow, this is nice. And it's gonna free up space in our other tanks so that we can get a lot more stuff rolling in for people.
Perfect, and so your idea is just to kind of do a frag rack in the center with lights hanging down from the ceiling, I'm assuming, or are you gonna clamp them onto the side, or?
You know, I'm a little bit like Dave, where I kind of wing things as I go. So honestly, we're gonna be setting this up, and I really don't know exactly where it's gonna go. But I'm hoping that it, at the end of the day, it gets in the really nice stuff, and we'll move things around.
All right, sweet. Well, I also see that you've got a reef mat set up, so nice, easy, and basically, you know, ongoing maintenance, right?
You know, I love the reef mats. I thought I'd show everybody how they work and. Show them the system. So, all right, bulkheads first.
All right.
Well, it might actually be perfect.
When do things go perfect, Ben?
I love when they go perfect. Yeah.
Quickly, we're gonna do a bit of a side adventure.
Yeah,
back
we're
to the water.
Check the salinity to see if it's right. We usually keep everything at 0.025, and it looks like we're low, so we're just gonna put more salt in.
So, really quickly, all of this stuff is just drying while the water is being prepared, and while we start to get the stuff together for the main return, which we'll be putting together right now, connecting it to the middle one there, just threw a main pump down into the sump. Okay, now I think we're getting to the stage where we're about to add the water in the return pipe, the return pump. As you can see, we've got the return line coming back in and the two overflows set up ready to go. Coming around the edge, the return pipes are now plumbed into the reef mat, and so we're just waiting on the return pump and the water. Where's this water, Ben?
We're working on it. All right, I'll let you fall, Kat.
All right, Kat, so we're ready to get some water pumping, I heard.
Yeah, so we're just going to, this is the sump of one of our matured systems. The water from here.
So this sump is connected to the main display out front. What is it, like 100 gallons or more?
That guy, I believe, is 250 in total.
250 plus this sump back here, which is like, looks like the same size as the tank. And then, so we're just gonna be replacing, doing a water change from the established tank into the new frag tank, and then replacing that with the new fresh water here. So the process has started. We'll check back in a little bit and continue on with the process, and hopefully we'll get that return pump turned on and we'll get some water in this main display. All right, so just checking in at the halfway point. As you can see, the frag tank is about 50% full and the sump is still getting water added. Probably about 20, 25 more gallons, and then it should be good for now. We'll need to do a second batch of water just to fill up the rest of the sump because it is massive, but that's not a problem for today. All right, just checking in again. So the main display is filled up.
Yeah, we're to help with the cycle, we're just gonna put some live rock from already our pre-established coral systems. And that's just gonna get it all ready for us. So we're just.
So the idea is just to get some of the rock in there to help displace some of this water. We're still, I don't know, 15, 20, 30 gallons shy of where it should be, but adding a couple of pounds of rock.
Yeah, these guys are full of bacteria, so it's gonna help cycle this guy fast. Ready for corals, stuff like that. Even though live rock is, some people call it a more outdated method, it's still, in my opinion, a really excellent method to get things started quick. Especially if you're starting a tank from scratch, it helps with that initial maturation process so much, which in my opinion is what makes most newbies leave the hobby. It's because you get all these algae blooms, you get stuff die, and it's just because you don't have a mature tank. And usually most people will last about 2 years in this hobby before they just quit, and that's really right before your tank is truly mature. So even like people say, oh, but there's gonna be pests and whatnot in live rock. I much rather deal with Aphasia, flatworms, every pest on the planet than an immature tank. Because that's gonna kill more stuff. Like pests are usually, there's usually treatments for them. There's usually stuff you can do about it. Really a maturation process is you can only wait. And even if it's crappy live rock, as long as it's full of bacteria, it's definitely worth it to start it. And I start my initial tank with dry rock and I'm never doing that again.
And so you've obviously got some live rock in here from a pre-existing tank. Mm-hmm. So what kind of a cycle process will this be then if you're using a live rock, you know, maybe fishless or fish in? What do you think?
Yeah, we're doing fish in for this guy just because we're just doing a pair of clowns from this captive red clown tank. And depending on who you ask, some people don't like cycling with fish. Which is fair. I think it's completely safe if you do it properly, you know what you're doing. Of course, we're going to be testing the ammonia levels in this tank. We're going to be adding in a full bottle of this Microbacter Start. It's essentially just to seed it extra more with bacteria. And yeah, the system is going to be heavily monitored. We're going to make sure nothing bad happens to these fish. Just because fish are such a good ammonia source, instead of just dosing in ammonia, it really gets it going better.
All right, so the frag tank is set up, plumbing is going, the return pump is on. We have the reef mat set up and that's working well. We've added some live rock into the bottom. Eventually we'll have to tighten up the bulkheads. As you can see, there's just the slightest leak, but I don't know what bulkheads don't leak. I'm sure Ben will address that. And now we're just going to be adding the fish. So what's going on here, Kat?
Yeah, so I cherry picked two of our really nice captive bred mocha orange storms. And they're just in the bag and we're gonna drop them in here just to temperature acclimate. And they're gonna be our new store pets and gonna help us get this tank start cycling, and then it's gonna be ready to go. Of course, we haven't put the egg crate in or any corals in yet, but we're gonna wait a little bit for that first.
Cool, and how long do you think it'll be before you start adding coral into the tank?
So, a lot of what you hear online is that you have to wait so-and-so 6 months before you add coral on. That's completely not true. The main reason people say that is because you'll have a lot of cycling and as well as biological instability in brand new tanks. We're probably gonna just start off with a few easy softies, see how they do. If they're doing great, we're gonna move up to stuff. As Ben mentioned before, it is supposed to be a high-end coral tank. While before we start putting in anything expensive in here, I'm probably gonna end up putting in more live rock just to get that cycle going faster.
Yeah, fair enough. And then I think we were speaking to Ben earlier. He's still gonna get some lights in, so he's gonna set up some hanging fixtures to the ceiling that'll light up the tank, but I think that he still needs to acquire the cable. He's got the lights ready, so that'll be in a part two. But what else, Kat? I think that's about it for this tank for the day, isn't it?
Yeah, it is about it. We'll release these guys in a few minutes. Other than that, check on everything tomorrow. Make sure Momia isn't up there. I highly doubt it will be because it's such a big tank for 2 pounds. But I believe this is almost 80 gallons of water volume in total. Because I believe this is like 40 to 60, and then the sump is another, 40 gallons? Yeah. Something like that. We'll get that done, and we're gonna get some nice corals in, guys.
Cool. All right, everybody, well, stay tuned, and we'll catch you on the next Benjamin's Aquarium Adventure.